Hi, America. I'm Good Patriot, and I'm a racist piece of trash. Well, not a regular racist. I'm actually a subconscious racist. I'm so racist that I don't even know how racist I am, or at least that's what I've been told. So to destroy racism, which apparently only exists against black people, I'm gonna have to do a few things. Number one, put a black box on my social media pages. This will ensure that I start working off my penance for being born white. And it will also make sure that my friends that aren't racist know that even though I've never done anything racist, that they know that I'm not racist either, and then somehow that's gonna help the black people. And number two, as a white person, I need to validate the existence of black people by saying the magic words, Black Lives Matter. Saying that actually shows that I think that my white opinion is superior and is needed to validate a black person's existence and worth. And black people acknowledging that they need to hear it from me is actually saying that they find their worth in my white opinion. But let's just ignore all the mental gymnastics of that and just say it anyway.
The magic words.
Black Lives Matter. There you go. Racism has been annihilated. Okay, let's cut the crap and get down to business. I haven't heard one person say that George Floyd's death was an unjust and tragic, and I have not seen any evidence that there's a racial motivation behind his death. But the media told you to feel bad, to get mad, and that it was okay to do stupid things because you've had years of anger and oppression built up. They lied, and you believed it. Why haven't you been mad at the dozen or two blacks killed in Chicago for the 57th weekend in a row? In 2018, white people committed violent crimes against black people almost 60,000 times. In the same year, black people committed violent crimes against black people almost 400,000 times. But y'all just want to talk about this one, not this one. I guess black lives don't really matter unless they're injured or killed by whites, and then the media tells you to be mad about it. Are you recognizing a pattern here? The media owns you. They tell you how to think and how to feel. This is a tragic death used by the higher-ups to bring destruction and division, and you were falling right into it. If you really cared about brown and black lives, you would bring down Planned Parenthood. They were literally built to murder black lives, but you go on and righteously boast your bullcrap hashtags, thinking that you're doing good, and at the same time, you're voting for more abortion rights so that they can rip apart black babies. Have you ever heard of the Barbary slave trade? That's the one where for hundreds of years, millions of white Europeans were kidnapped and enslaved in North Africa. Kind of weird that we never hear talk about that example of slavery, right? How about the police killings of Kelly Thomas and Duncan Limp? Haven't heard of them? I'm not surprised. Did you know that black on white crime is over 9 times higher than white on black crime? I bet you didn't. That's because it doesn't fit their agenda to make you think that black and brown people are the perpetual victim and that white people are the privileged, power-hungry murderers. Did you also know that the CIA has been conducting psychological operations on us for decades using our media?
I don't even get that. What?
This isn't about race. This is about distracting you from the real enemy and manipulating you to think in a certain way. To the whites, who of you have actually acted out in an evil way against a black person just because they're black? I haven't, ever, and I'm guessing that a very large majority of you haven't either. You're not racist, so stop feeling guilty. I don't have to prove my non-racism to anybody. I just live it. I don't owe black people, I don't owe the media, I don't owe some stupid social media influencer celebrity campaign anything. And I will not ever apologize simply for being white. And I will never apologize that my hard work got me to where I am. These looters and rioters have sold their integrity for $15 an hour and a stolen pair of shoes. They are not oppressed. White, black, or brown. They are thieves, murderers, and they deserve no sympathy. I have gotten on my knees and wept over these people and prayed that God removes the blindness from their eyes and that they turn from their evil ways. But so help me God, if one of you comes near me or someone near me and threatens our livelihood or our lives, I will not hesitate to neutralize your threat. To the black people that got their peaceful protest hijacked by these evil animals, I am truly sorry. George's death was a disgusting crime, but there are also disgusting crimes committed every day against all races. We just don't get told to be upset about them. Let this wake you up to the fact that you are being used as a pawn in a very calculated game of good versus evil. We all are, and that's why we need to stick together and stop letting them dictate how we feel, what we do, and how we think. Don't believe the lie that you can blame your way to success and riot your way to justice. The end of this video is all scripted out, but I'm just not feeling it, so I'm just gonna talk plainly with you guys. I'm tired. I'm tired of all this bullcrap, and we need to stop being angry at each other and be angry at the people that are actually systematically trying to oppress and control us. And until we do that, they're gonna win. To the believers out there, I just feel like I'm supposed to tell you guys to put on the full armor of God and get on your face in prayer and pray over our country and our world, because we are in a serious battle right now. Thank you for watching. I hope you resonated with some of the thoughts in this video and that it was encouraging and that you realize that I'm coming from a place of tough love, because that's what's needed right now. I'm done with political correctness and sugarcoating. In fact, I actually never do it. But if you're not used to that, welcome to the page of Good Patriot. Love you guys. Stay safe and God bless. I'll see you soon.